Hello friends, now in this session we'll see functions and pointers in C. These are the contents of this session: how to pass an array to function, how to pass the string, how to pass the structure to the function, function to pointers, and again a interesting topic, array of functions to pointers. These are the objectives of today's session. You will be able to make use of pointers with functions in C, implement functions using call by reference, and identify the importance of call by reference. Now let's see how to pass an array to function. An array, 1D array, 2D array, or a character array is nothing but a string. So now first of all, let's start with passing 1D array to function. One example is given where in main program or in main function, num array is declared of type integer. Some of the values are assigned at the time of declaration itself, and display function is called by passing two parameters to that function. First one, here we are passing the address of num array of the zeroth element, address of zeroth element of the array num. Now here, as we are passing the address over here, in the definition of a display function, that address should be collected in pointer type variable only, because only the pointer type variable can hold the address. And the second parameter is nothing but the size of array that is get collected in variable n. This is nothing but the passing 1D array to the function, where base address of the 1D array is passed, the reference of 1D array is passed to the function at the time of calling the function, and in the definition the address is collected in a pointer type variable. What will be the output of this program? Now here, element is displayed one by one by displaying value at the address available j. As j is holding the base address of array, when I is 0, it displays the first element 24. J++ is nothing but the increment of pointer to point to next element or to point to next address location. This J++ is incremented by 1 to go to next address location. Can we increment the pointer type variable? Yes, we can, as the pointer type variable can be incremented and will go to next address location. By execution of this for loop, the next time I will become 1, j is already pointing to next address location, and it displays the value available at the next address location is nothing but 34, and it will give the output, that is 24, 34, 12, 44, 56 and 17 for this particular program. This is the way how to pass 1D array, the base address of array, to a function with the call by reference type. Now let's go through how to pass 2D array to function. Three different ways or three different functions are given over here, with which we can say that we can pass 2D array to function in three different ways. Let's go through the definition of first display function, where while calling the function A, that is base address of the array, name of array is nothing but base address, is passed to function, is collected in a pointer type variable Q. Now here, with the help of formula, that is value at the address, base address plus I is nothing but the row number, multiply with the number of columns declared in 2D array plus j is nothing but the column number. With this formula, we can access all the elements of the array. Is the first way how to pass 2D array to the function. The second way is, again we are passing the base address. In this show function, we are passing the base address of array, 2D array, is get collected in a pointer type variable q. With this declaration, it indicates that this is a 2D array where the number of columns are 4, as the number of columns, the numbers should be declared over here, mentioned over here, to indicate that ki how many number of columns are there. It's not necessary to mention the number of rows, but it's mandatory to mention the number of columns. Now here p is another pointer type variable is declared, and for every p, the base address plus ith row is assigned to p. With the either for loop, we are going to display value available at the base address of the row plus jth column. With this representation, we can display all the values which are available in our 2D array. And the third way is again the same thing, but here we are not going to use any pointer variable. This is just a simple array in which we are collecting the base address of the array A. And again the same thing, the number of rows is not mandatory, is not shown over here, declared over here, but the number of columns, it is mandatory and it is declared over here. And with the simple subscript I and j, that is row number and column number, we can display the array. So three different ways are there with which we can access the 2D array by passing its base address to the function. Now go forward, how to pass the strings to function. Strings are nothing but the 1D array. It is 1D array of characters. So the base address of 1D array is passed to the function in the function called getS as well as display string. And here the same base address is collected in the array and we can access the string. It's very simple, as you can implement the implementation of or passing the 1D array to the function as it is of type integer. The same thing can be done with the help of strings. Now go forward for how to pass structure to function using pointers. Example of structure is declared over here. Its variable is declared with initialization of structure with some values, and here function call with the or by passing the address of b1 variable. Address, as we are going to pass, we need to collect into a pointer type variable. We need to take care of the data type of the variable whose address we are going to store in this b variable, as the address of structure variable we are going to pass, the data type of this pointer type variable should be struct book. The data type should match this concept. Already we have gone through the first session of pointers in C. The same concept is used over here, and with the arrow operator, we can access all the members of structure by using a pointer type variable b. Simple address, base address is passed over here. It is collected in a pointer type variable. We need to take care of the data type. Data type should match of both the variables b1 and b, and with the help of arrow operator, we can access all the members of the structure book over here. Now let's consider we are having an array of structure with us. How to implement a program by passing the base address of array of structure. Now again same thing, as it is an array array that may be of type integer, that may be of type character, that may be of type float, or that may be of type structure. The same concept is there, is like the base address is passed over here in the accept function or in print function. Base address of the array is passed over here. S is the name of array of structure, and collecting it in the array again in the function definition will work properly. Only that you need to take care of the data type. Again, S is the address of structure type variable whose data type is struct example. The same way, SPTR is an array whose data type is struct example. This SPTR and the subscript I or index I will access all the members, that is num1 and num2, who belongs to struct example with the help of dot operator. Rest of things are same in the print function. Now a important concept is pointer to functions. Here one function is declared, normal function declaration is here, but here this is the function used or declared as a pointer. FPTR, function PTR, is a pointer to function FUN. Address of fun variable, this fun function, address of fun function is assigned to fun PTR. It's a pointer type variable, and the parameters we are going to pass is a single parameter of type integer. This line is just same as of this type of declaration where a pointer is declared, fun pointer, and the parameters declared over here, and the address of fun function is assigned to fun pointer. These two lines can be combined in this single line. And how to invoke this fun pointer through our program? So this pointer, fun pointer, we need to pass one integer type value to this function. It is having the base address of a function FUN. It goes to that address location and it executes this function by printing or by displaying a statement like value of A is %D, is nothing but, as we have passed the value 10, 10 is collected in variable A and it displays the A. Unlike a normal pointers, a function pointer points to code, not to data. Typically, a function pointer stores the start of executable code. Why do we need extra bracket around the function pointer like FUNPTR in above example? If we'll remove this, it will look like this and is nothing but the function that returns a pointer, and is not the case with our example. We are pointing to function, that's why we need extra brackets in this example. And now the last concept is array of function of pointers, array of function pointers. Can we define the array of functions? Yes. We need to take care of, there are multiple functions in your program having the same number of parameters with same data type with the same sequence. Then and then only we can form an array of function pointers. Now here function pointer is declared, pointer function pointer array. Array size is not declared over here, but here we are initializing its addresses by giving the name of all these functions. Having two parameters only, both are of type integer, and it is maintaining the sequence. How to call this function? We have accepted a choice from a user. We have assigned a value A and B at the time of declaration itself, and we are calling a function by passing a ch value as a subscript to the array of pointers of a function by passing the value A and B. And it, according to choice accepted by the user, it goes to according to function. If it is 0, it executes add function. If it is 1, it will execute a subtract function. And if it is 2, it will execute multiply function. In this way, we can declare array of function of pointers. Thank you.